Hey guys! Bit of a bonus video here. I'm finally getting the hang of the manual torpedo aiming with carriers, and I thought I'd put together a very short instructional how-to video to those of you who are struggling with this mechanic at the moment. First of all, there is another great video out there from iChase Gaming, who also streams World of Warships. I put the link to his video in the description below. I suggest to check it out, I learned a lot from it as well. There was also a very informative post on the forums with some hand-drawn explanation, but I just can't seem to find it again. If any of you runs into it before I do, please post the link in the comments below to help out your fellow gamers. So without any further bullshit, let's cut to the fun part. When playing carriers in World of Warships, your primary damage dealers will be your torpedo bombers. Your basic choice with firing them is to use the auto-aim system by just simply left-clicking on the target ship. First, we will have a look at optimizing this mode. Using auto-aim is useful for beginners as it helps to launch the torpedoes at a reasonable angle, but it releases the torps quite far away from the target ship, and they also fan out over a larger area, allowing ships to escape with relative ease if they pay attention. There are, however, a couple of things you can do to improve your success rate and make this a more reliable, even if limited, damage source, as against reasonable players you can expect only 2 to 4 hits per run on average. First of all, make sure to give the order to the planes at a distance. The white circle appearing around your target is the limit where the planes can start their attack run, while the green zone shows you how the torpedoes will fan out. If they are already past this limit or do not have enough space to turn on the target outside this circle, they will just derp around the edge trying to get into an attack position. This is especially dangerous later on when attacking higher tier battleships with some heavy duty AA guns, as they will just shoot you down before you even can say torpedo. Secondly, try to attack from an about 90 degree angle. This means approach the ship parallel to it and then turn onto its side for the attack run. Now we will use this with the manual aiming as well, so get used to it now. Should you approach from a less effective angle, or should the ship start to turn to avoid you, you can always use the green slider on the white circle to set the direction of your torpedoes. Don't forget to use this when necessary, otherwise they will easily outmaneuver you. At the same time, keep in mind that if you keep moving the slider, the planes will have to correct their trajectory every time, and in the end they might get into a situation where they are not able to make the run directly, and you end up in the exact same uncomfortable situation that we discussed in the previous point. The third and most important point is, get your hands on 2 torpedo bomber squadrons and put your enemy in a nasty crossfire. This maximizes your damage and makes it really difficult for the enemy to completely dodge all the torps if you made it right. You can do this by either attacking from the same side of the ship but at different angles, or even better, attacking from both sides of the ship to make it extremely nasty. For maximum effect, you can also opt to release the second wave of torpedoes a few seconds after the first one, once the ship started turning trying to avoid the first salvo. If you do this, they will effectively turn into your second salvo of torpedoes, guaranteeing at least a few hits. Now let's have a look at 2 quick examples of this in the following clips. And as this is the easy part, I think we need some chill music for this. Alright, here we are in example 1. And I think it's time we put that unfortunate battleship into a nice little crossfire. So I have my 2 torpedo squadrons selected. And if you see, I just simply click on the battleship with my torpedo squadron, adjust the aim with that little green slider that I can move along the white circle around the ship, and I send one of my torpedo squadrons over to the left, the other one is attacking from the right, and I adjust the aim so the path of the torpedoes will cross from both sides the path of the battleship. Now notice here, I don't approach here from a perfect angle, so I can't really touch the aim again, otherwise the planes will not be able to fire the torpedoes in with one run. And there we go, both torpedoes, salvos in the water, and that unfortunate guy has absolutely no chance to avoid all of the torpedoes. Might be only 3 torpedo hits, but it was pretty much guaranteed damage. And here we are in example 2. Another battleship approaching. This time we will attack him with both squadrons from the same side. So what I'm doing One of the squadrons I sent straight towards the ship, the other I set on a slightly different trajectory, and then with both of the squadrons I just click on the battleship, one from there and the other one from there, and as they are in different positions, the torpedoes will cross each other's path. So the two fins will come together just around at the time when they meet the ship, meaning that that poor guy has not much chance avoiding our salvos, and indeed we score 4 hits in total. Easy as pie. When you are comfortable with the auto-aim system, it's time to ramp things up a notch and get those amazing torpedo runs you always wanted with 8 or more direct hits with one run. It won't be easy, and you have to learn it for a while, as you have to judge the distance and the speed of the ships perfectly. It is really easy to completely miss this way, so be prepared for some frustration. It's maybe a good idea to start applying this method on stationary targets first, like AFK players, or maybe if someone did successfully get himself stuck on an island or on the side of the map. Later on, move on to slower moving targets, then full-speed battleships, and eventually the nimble cruisers. The main difference with this aiming mode is that you now have to press and hold the Alt key and place the white circle with the green torpedo zone completely by yourself, estimating where the ship will be by the time your torps get there. The torpedoes will now move in a narrow, straight line, maximizing both damage potential and the chance to miss completely. So naturally, also here there are a couple of important factors that you should keep in mind. First of all, the white circle is still your limit. If you place it down so your planes are already in it, they will have to turn around and come back again, messing up your aim completely and probably killing themselves in the incoming flak. Secondly, while you can now place the start of the drop much closer to the ship, giving them much less chance to react, you still need to give your torps enough time to arm themselves, or they will just bounce off the side of the enemy ship without doing any damage. They are armed and ready to blow stuff up when the green indicators pop up above them. To find the sweet spot, it is a good idea to place the start of the drop about as far from the enemy ship as the length of the ship itself. Thirdly, attacking at a 90 degree angle is now super crucial to maximize your runs. With a well-aimed shot, this way you can send your torpedoes all in the side of that big fat ugly battleship. And lastly, the most tricky part, judging how much you have to lead your torpedoes. Regarding the speed of your planes and torpedoes, you can expect that it will take about the same time for your planes to get to the drop zone from the white circle as it will take your torpedoes to get to the ship from the drop zone. Now, this is only true if you place the drop zone at the correct distance, of course. Regarding considering the speed of the ship, well, you just have to get the feel of it. But I did use a method you might want to try out, using the width of the green torpedo line as an indicator. For the sake of this video, let's call the width of this green indicator 1 unit. Now, this all might sound a bit messy, but you will see what I mean from the videos. So right now, here's a quick guide for the perfect size shots. Against battleships moving at their regular speed, try to set the green line in a way so the ship will be just 1 unit away from it when the torpedoes enter the water. For slower moving targets, try half a unit between the ship and the green line. For cruisers, try 2 units, otherwise the torpedoes will just arrive behind them as they move much faster. Now, as we know that it takes the same time from the white circle to the drop zone, which is the beginning of your green line, we just have to add 1 unit in each case when we calculate the distance from the edge of the white circle. This means that when I'm making the attack run against a battleship, for example, I place the green line so at the moment when the planes enter the white circle, the tip of the ship should be 2 green lines away from where my torpedoes will cross her path. If I manage this right, the ship should get to 1 green line distance when the torpedoes are launched, and it will exactly cross the path of the torpedoes when they meet. That's the theory anyway, but I hope it will be a good starting point for you until you can judge it for yourself. Just one more hint before we look at the videos. Don't try to guess where the edge of the white circle will be. Place the marker before that. You can refine your aim until you eventually reach it, but if you miss it, then your planes will have to turn back, and more often than not, your run has been ruined. But I think I confused you enough already. Let me show you with some examples how I do it. Alright, here is the real deal. Now I laid my eyes on a tier 7 Nagato, These battleships are tough. But I have two torpedo squadrons coming just in the perfect about 90 degree angle. They are grouped together, and so I will release them both at the same time. This also means that I really have to aim well. So, you see, I'm still quite far away from the white circle. I place my aim, and I have enough time to readjust. And by the time they enter the white circle, the ship is about one green line away from my actual aim. Probably a little bit closer this time. And look at that poor guy. I'm sorry, chap, it's nothing personal. And here we are again. We spotted ourselves a slightly out of position battleship moving towards that little island. He is moving at full speed. So we know that means we have to leave about one green line between our aim and the tip of the ship by the time we enter the white circle. Now he notices us and starts to turn, but that's alright. We can just change our approach and attack from the other side. And as he continues to turn, he will show us perfectly his sides. So right now, it's time to turn and place the aim. Notice that I place the start of the green zone about as far away from the ship as the ship's length as well. And there we go. He eats all of our torpedoes. It's not that hard once you get the hang of it, but it will take some practice. Happy hunting, guys!